for years and years, for as long as sin has been here in the world. But Lord, we hear about more and more, if for no other reason, that we just have better ways of communicating today. But Lord, our hearts are moved every time we see these type of things. So Lord, we just pray that you would just meet the needs, Father, that even in the midst of these horrible kind of things, that you would just be glorified. Lord, for what she mentioned about the work slowdown, not only with her, Lord, but somebody just this evening says something just in passing that I know that their business has slowed down with some things. Father, I pray that you will bring forth that which is needed,
yes,
not only in provision, but also in work, in business, and that type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Father, that you would make these things happen. Mm-hmm. And we thank you in Jesus'
yes.
name. Thank
you. You want to take that call?
Oh, sure. Welcome to Prayer Line. How can we pray for you?
Yeah, I would like for you to pray for Royce Arrington and Karen Fortner. They've both been in the hospital.
Okay.
Miss Janet.
Yeah, I thought I recognized Janet. I thought that was you.
And pray for my grandma.
Okay.
Okay.
We will pray for them right now. Thank you a lot,
Janet.
Bye-bye. I bet that was Lisa in the background, too. They're good friends. Oh, thank you, Lord. Our number is 739-5686, so give us a call as we continue to pray. Go ahead, Sway.
Well, Father, I want to lift up Barbara to you. Nancy said she's undergoing some tests, Lord, and I pray, God, for a good report. And for Cindy, Father, I ask that you meet her where her point of need is, Lord, and that you would provide for her, Lord, and for Nancy's family. She mentioned several people, Louise, who needs a touch from you, Lord. And Father, what crossed my mind is in any of these situations, if there is a need for repentance, Lord, I pray, God, that that your Holy Spirit would convict of sin and that there would be genuine repentance, Lord, and that you would bless. Father, we don't hear a whole lot taught about repentance much nowadays, Lord. There's always such a feel-good gospel being presented with no repentance message, Lord. But I pray, Father, that for any situations that have arisen because of sin, Lord, that you would make that known to us and that we would be faithful to repent, to turn totally away from that sin, and to press on to the calling that you have placed before us, Lord. I pray that we would walk in a manner worthy of our calling. Father, I ask that you be with those that Janet has mentioned with, is it Royce? Is that what she said?
Royce
and Karen.
Yeah.
I pray, God, that you would touch them, Lord, with your healing hand. I pray that you would provide for their needs, Lord. I pray that you would be their all in all. I pray, God, that you would minister to them as only you can. And for Janet's grandmother, Lord, I pray that you would bless her with good health, Lord, and with provision and with everything that she needs, Lord. And I pray, God, for a touch from you for every single person that has been brought forth tonight, Lord. I pray for the miraculous in each one of their lives. I pray, God, that you would meet them at their point of need, that you would answer their cries unto you, Lord.
Yes.
And for those who are lost, I pray for their salvation. I pray that your Spirit would draw them unto you, that they would realize that they're lost. They would realize that doing things their own way has not gotten them anywhere, Lord, and that they need a Savior and they need Jesus to be their Savior and their Lord. And I pray, God, that you would turn every situation around for your glory and for the good of those who call upon your name, Lord.
Yes. Thank you, Father. Thank you. And Lord, I pray that you'll be with John this evening, Lord, that you will just bless him and for his brother-in-law, right? His brother-in-law was supposed to be out of town today. Lord, in relationship to some physical things. So, Father, just continue to heal him and bless him. Let's take this call here real quick. Welcome to Prayer Line. How can we pray for you?
Hey, it's me again.
Hey.
I left off a name on my prayer list. My fault. It's Penny Burkett. She had some stomach had to have surgery on her stomach. She had to have two operations.
Okay.
And I don't know whether she's still in the hospital or not.
Okay.
Okay. We will lift her
we
up.
We will pray for her right
okay.
now.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Say what, before we pray for her, Penny, we're going to take a break real quick, and then we'll come back for the last segment. So stay with us. Welcome back to Prayerline. Let's take this call here. Hello, welcome to Prayerline. How can
Hi.
We pray for you?
Some people in my Sunday school class.
Uh-huh.
Her husband is in the hospital, but they're going to run some tests on him tomorrow, but they don't know what's wrong with him.
Okay.
His wife's name is CJ, and her husband's name Ed Perry, and
okay.
they're in Cullman.
Okay.
In room 413. They need the prayers real bad.
Okay.
Okay.
We will pray for them right now.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
And one more call here. Welcome to Prayer Line. How can we pray for you?
Hey, Prayer Warrior. I just got in, buddy. I didn't think I was going to be able to make it tonight.
Well, we just prayed for you, so you're covered.
Did you really?
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
You prayed for Danny?
Yeah.
Yes, we did.
Well, they're probably back, but now I hadn't called. I just got home.
Okay, we prayed for them, and I prayed for you, too, man.
Hey, you're a wonderful man. I got to go take a shower.
Okay.
Love y'all.
Love you, man. Bye-bye. Oh, that's great. That's great. Thank you, Lord. Again, our number is 739-5686. We've got a couple more minutes, so give us a call real quick, and we'll pray for you, okay? Go ahead, babe.
Father, I pray for a rapid recovery for Penny from stomach surgery,
yes.
Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I pray, God, that whatever was wrong is now fixed in the name of Jesus. Mm. And that was Cindy that called, right?
Yeah, it was. Sounded like Cindy, yeah.
Lord, I pray for Cindy's friend CJ and her husband.
Ed?
Mm-hmm.
I think so.
Percy? Is that what she said? Ed Percy?
Or Perry? Yeah, something like that.
Ed Perry, yeah. I don't have my glasses on. I'm sorry. I pray, Father, that you would intervene. I know he's going to have tests to determine what's wrong, but I pray, Lord, that when the tests are run, they find that there's nothing wrong, and I pray, God, that all symptoms that pointed that there was something wrong will be totally gone, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I pray that you would intervene in your power and in your glory, Lord. And we will give you all the praise, honor, and glory.
Thank you.
And Father, I lift up Michael to you, and I pray, God, for total deliverance for him and for healing for pain in Jesus' name.
Thank you. Let's take this call here. Welcome to Prayer Line. How can we pray for you?
Yeah, I would love for you to pray for Tess. She's
going
to have surgery on her wrist again.
Yeah, Tess Scott? Yeah.
Okay,
we'll pray for her. Thank you,
Lord. Sure.
Bye-bye. Oh, thank you, Lord. 739-5686. We've got about a minute right here. Mm-hmm. And so, Lord, I thank you for Tess. And I thank you for everybody who's calling saying, pray for her, pray for her. Lord, just touch that hand. Father, we see a couple of places in Scripture right there where you just reached out and you just healed. And Lord, we do give you thanks for what you have allowed men to